Welcome everybody to my channel. Hello, hello. I am Yan and today we are listening to another comeback. And I don't think I have watched or, reacted to one of his MVs yet, so that's exciting. But I do know a little bit about him. And it is none other than Kang Daniel, or Daniel Kang, if you will. And so, yeah, he was from Produce and 101, and he was first place, I believe, right? And so, after 101 disbanded, he had his own solo performances. I guess he became a soloist and still is. And he has his own company now? I was like, what? But anyways, congratulations. It's good to see that Produce members are able to be in a group or become soloists. So today we are listening to the song called Paranoia. Maybe he's paranoid at something, who knows. I really look forward to his choreography and also just seeing what this MV is all about. So let's check it out right now. Alright, not much to see, but let's check out Kang Daniel's Paranoia.
Am I just crazy? You're dreaming awake. 이제는 I can't escape. 반복된 하루에 무뎌져 가. Oh why? No.
Daniel is able to have great facial expressions and acting skills, of course dancing and singing and rapping, but I also want to give a pat on the back for those who did the camera work, right, filming and also editing with those effects. That just made it extra goosebumpy and extra creepy, and it just made this and be the way it should be, right? Paranoia, paranoid, right? There's something that's bothering him, probably more than one thing bothering him based on the MV, but it's just, wow, everyone did a great job and it really did it. Like, it was creepy, it was a little scary, it was mysterious, it was a little frightening, and also cool with the dancing. Wow. We see here Daniel sleeping, and at first I was like, okay, there's not much, but there are just glimpses of freakiness with that hand, and then we transition with the eyes, and then it's just, oh yeah, his eye transition to that light. I was like, that was pretty creative. And then we see a very dark scene here. There are a lot of dark scenes, but we start out with a very dark scene, and we see the dancers supporting Daniel and just having a feel of mystery, of creepiness, of like spiders crawling. That's what I felt. And we can tell that in this room that Daniel was in, he may have some problems, or he's seeing illusions, he's hallucinated in some ways, or paranoid, because there are cameras watching him and he is watching himself, right, with all the TV screens showing him in his room. And we see the picture right in the middle, which is like forming and just kind of looking a little more and more twisted. We know, or at least what I thought, we know that Daniel is going a little crazy here. And he did a great job portraying that, by the way. He had a lot of outfits. This is one of them. I'm going to call it the semi-moon outfit. And it just represented that whiskey pouring. And so like that type of transitioning was phenomenal. And we just see him in various places with dancers and dancing, looking a little out of place, a little possessed, like, if you will. I'm trying to think of other words, but he is doing a great job, so I'm low on words already, vocabulary words. This is one of the places where he danced a lot with the dancers. We see it's like kind of a, it looks like a Pokeball now for a second. Kind of like, huh, but not a Pokeball that you want to be in. Anyways, so there are lots of shards and sparks, and it kind of looks like a flower. I'm not really sure what it is, but in the middle, it's like an eye. And there are lots of symbolisms and patterns with the eye. So maybe one eye sees kind of like what's real and what's true, and the other eye is just like seeing all these illusions and seeing all these dark things that's going on. It could be this person has gone crazy because they broke up in a relationship. But then again, I don't know what he's really saying other than some of the English parts, so I will check the translation later. Then we see him in a more normal setting, right, in a more realistic place, but he is by himself and it looks like he's struggling between reality and in this world, right? So different makeup, different styles can show that maybe he has multiple personalities, right? Split personalities, if not multiple. So that can also be a possibility. I just want to say his English was really good. Sometimes artists, they add English words, and I didn't know they said some things in English until I looked at the translation, but I was able to catch and hear, and it was very clear. So good job working on your English skills as well. I also love the setting here, and we only see like seconds of it, so I'm not really sure, but it looks like he's under the sea in a metallic watery place, very curtainy like. It looks like he's drowning and suffocating, but I want to watch behind the scenes of how he does it, because right now it looks like he looks a little strange from this angle. It looks like he's being sucked into this metallic curtain, but other times we see him kind of trapped underwater. And so I really like that, because it really feels, it shows how he felt, you know, as a character, not the real Daniel, but in this MV. We also see him in this outfit where he has like a turtleneck with a lot of holes cut out, and it seems like maybe he could be hurting himself, and he doesn't even know. He's ruining his clothing and he doesn't even know because he's just a little insane, a little cray cray. And there are a few, oh yeah, there's another scene right here. Yeah, I'd love to see how this all works out, or if it's just all CG, right? I'm sure some of it is, but how did they do it? I really am curious about it. And we see him again dancing more, going back and forth with different personalities, different, I guess, outfits and styles. And this eye is becoming more and more distinct and clear. And so that's more of a symbol now that I'm looking back at it. The dancers did a really good job, and we can see they each only have one eye cut open, like the hole, so they can see. So again, it could be like Daniel is going crazy. He's kind of blinded, but he sees like darkness and crazy things around him instead of maybe love and hope and normal things, if you will. But I thought the choreography was very strong. It gave that like zombie feel, that creepy, insane feel, but also very cool and slick, and some moves are more powerful than others, and it just really makes this MV more, you know, an extra layer of like awesomeness. I'm usually not a fan of creepy things, but the way they did it, it's good. Like, I wasn't afraid, but I usually lean towards more happy things, but this was a really great production. And then we see this eye. I guess it's more clear now instead of the Pokeball because of the angle we are filming at. So I think it is an eye that represents him or what he sees. And we are back in his room. I love it when he's in this setting, when he's acting terrified or frightened or anxious, because he did a great job acting. Like, I could really feel that. And with the music and with the melody, it really packs a punch to it. We see him back in this room, right? And he's being shrouded by this weird cloud blanket thing, and it looks like he is hurting himself, right? This darkness is kind of tormenting Daniel in this MV. And then we see him with the red eye, right, which is the Pokeball, and then the bird's eye view, right? And so it looks like he is kind of possessed and he can't escape it. He is trapped, and he has trapped himself. This part is a little bloody, but it says failure, right? So it looks like he's slowly being possessed by failure, which is a little sad. I guess maybe if it says failure, is it because a lot of things are going bad or you're not doing well that people are more and more upset and depressed and losing hope? Is that what Daniel's trying to portray? I will probably have to listen to his interpretation as well. But it looks like he got stabbed and he's about to pass out and maybe not make it. Or maybe there'll be part two where he is like reborn again. I don't know, but it's very sad, very touchy for sure. We can see he has contact lens here, which is like the other eye. So it shows that he has maybe a different personality or is seeing things as well. So yeah, the says 15 years old and up because some parts can be a little creepy just with all the makeup. And so that's understandable, but this Paranoia MV really did show that Daniel was paranoid and was just going crazy. So I am very happy to see that he successfully did and showed what he wanted to show. So yeah, thank you for watching it with me. Continue to support Kang Daniel and listen to Paranoia and also his other songs too. Thanks for watching.